which each of these school audits, it's a constant reminder for the need for better solutions so we can better position our children for the future. In recent years, Steelton-Highspire School District has been very aware of its troubling financial situation. I can vouch for the former superintendent, Dr. Utley, and the current one, Dr. Castaneto, that they looked at every possible option to cut and reduce spending. I believe in times of austerity, it forces us to streamline and become more efficient, which is a good thing. But when it goes beyond that, where cuts are being made to full-day kindergarten, language classes, teachers' aides, busing, and other important programs, we begin to chip away at the quality of public education, and the students fall behind. We need a new funding formula that reflects the needs of today. I support House Bill 1738, which passed in the House last month. It takes a hard look at how we fund schools through a commission. Instead of allocating the same amount or less than every year, it takes account of each school district's needs and unique challenges, which will determine the amount given. This way, the state can adequately fund school districts and throw out the cookie cutter, outdated formula that isn't working anymore. Steel High can and will work on the important issues and housekeeping issues mentioned by the Auditor General. We will do that. But we can do better at working closely and drawing upon the Department of Education's resources and programs. It's my job to make sure that these two parties connect. I agree with the recommendations to institute budget projections beyond the next fiscal year, provide the school board with monthly updates on key financial benchmarks so they can monitor the financial situation. These are common sense practices that should be done. In the meantime, I will continue to work on adequate funding to give our students a chance for a successful career. As we all know, the jobs are slowly coming back, but our students must be ready and prepared for them. Education, public education, needs to be a high priority.